Again, with the same topic, application of derivatives, and under this we were solving questions on tangents and normals. That is the equation of a tangent and equation of a normal. So this was exercise 6.3. Some of questions I had solved yesterday. So let us see the next questions. So first question I am to take, it is the 10th one, and question says that you have to find the equations of all the lines having slope as -1 and that are tangents to the curve whose equation is y equal to 1 upon x minus 1 and x is not equal to 0, 1. So this is the question number 10. So you have to draw the lines having the slope minus 1 and that the tangents, that lines are tangents to this curve. So I have to find, if I have to find the equation of tangent, so first I must have the slope. So yesterday I had written two formulas. One was equation of tangent line is given by formula y minus y1 m into x minus x1. So this is the formula we use for finding the slope, find the equation of a tangent line, and for finding equation of normal line we have a formula y minus y1 equal to m dash x minus x1. This is called the formula for calculating the equation of a normal line, and this is the formula for calculating equation of a tangent line. So in diagram also I had shown, if this is a curve whose equation is y equal to fx and this is a point at which a line meets, and this is called a contact point, and this is tangent line which meets the curve at one point. And if I have draw a line, this is called normal line. So this is normal line and this is tangent line. So tangent line and normal line, they are perpendicular to each other. So if I have to find the normal line equation, this formula will be used, and if I have to find the equation of tangent line, this formula will be used. So you will remember these two formulas. So in this question we have to draw the lines whose slope is given to -1, and those lines must be tangent on this curve. So let us find slope of this curve by differentiating this. So its slope will be dy upon dx, d upon dx of 1 upon x minus 1, and this will equal to minus 1 upon x minus 1 whole square. So while doing derivatives, number of questions you had solved, this was quotient formula of derivative we used here. So I have correctly written this dy upon dx of tangent line equal to x minus 1 its whole square. So this is the slope of the tangent line on the given curve. Now slope of line is given to be minus 1. Also dy upon dx is minus 1. So that means both are the slopes of the tangent line. So that means they will be equal. And minus 1 gets cancelled. So x minus 1 whole square equals to 1. This means x minus 1 square equal to 1. That means it is quadratic. So x minus 1 will equal to plus 1. X minus 1 will equal to minus 1. So this will give me the value of x as 2. And this will give the value of x as 0. So these are the two points. Now if I put the value of these two points in equation of curve, I can get the value of y. So at x equal to 2, the value of y will be 1 upon 2 minus 1, that is 1 upon 1. So my point, one point is x equal to 2, y equal to 1. So 2, 1, this is one of the point, and the second point at x equal to 0, I will have the y coordinate as 1 upon x minus 1, that is 1 upon x is 0, minus 1, this is minus 1, so that means point is 0, minus 1. So I have these two points, number 1, number 2. So through these two points and slope minus 1, two tangent lines can be drawn. So I can draw two tangent lines which are having slope minus 1 and which are passing through these two points. So let us draw the equation of these tangent lines. Now I have to draw equation of tangent lines. And those equations will be given by the formula equation of tangent line passing through point 21 and having slope as minus 1. This will be y minus y1 m x minus x1. So this formula, just I have shown the equation of tangent. So y1 is 1, m is minus 1, which is slope, x minus x1, it is 2. So y minus 1 is equal to minus x plus 2. I'll transfer this to this side. X plus y minus 1 minus 2 equal to 0. Or x plus y minus 3 equal to 0. So this is equation of tangent line on the curve y equal to 1 minus x. Also another tangent line equation I can draw by using the same formula. So this is one of the equation of tangent line on the given curve. So again, equation of tangent line with slope as minus 1 and passing through my second point, that is 0 minus 1. This will be given by y minus y1 equal to m dash into x minus x1. So y minus y1, it is minus 1, it will become plus 1, slope, that is minus 1, x minus x1, this is 0. So y plus 1 equal to minus x, or I can say x plus y plus 1 equal to 0. So this is equation of tangent line on a given curve at the point which is 0 minus 1. So two tangent lines are meeting this equation of the curve. So in this way, this question was to be solved. Question number 11 and 12, they are similar to this question. You can try yourself. 10th I have solved, 11 and 12, they are the same questions. You can solve. So let me take question number 13. So 13th question is an important one. So then let us solve 13. This was 10th one. The points we have to find on the curve whose equation is x square upon 9, y square upon 16 equal to 1, at which tangents are number 1, he says, parallel to x axis, and number 2, he says, tangents are parallel to y axis. So this is the question. You have to find points on this curve at which tangents drawn on this curve, they are parallel to x-axis, and tangents drawn on this curve is parallel to y-axis. So there are two parts. Let us solve equation of curve, that is x square upon 9, y square upon 16 equal to 1. So first you might have red conics. This was chapter in 11th class, conics. In conics there were the geometrical figures like parabola, then ellipse, then hyperbola, then these type of diagrams you might have read in conics. So this is, if you remember, is the equation of an ellipse. So ellipses are of two type. One is having its major axis on x-axis. This ellipse is having its major axis on x-axis, and this is an ellipse which is having its major axis on y-axis. So these geometrical figures you might have read in conics if you remember. So this is the curve of a ellipse. So this is ellipse. So this is ellipse, and we have to find the points on this curve which are tangent parallel to x-axis and y-axis. So if I have to find the equation of tangent on this ellipse, I will have to find its slope. So if I differentiate with respect to x, this as its derivative will be 2x upon 9, and here 2y dy upon dx upon 16 equal to 0. 1 is constant, its derivative will be 0. So from here, the value of dy upon dx can I find 2x upon 9 plus y upon 8 into dy upon dx equal to 0. Or I can say y upon 8 dy upon dx equals to minus 9 2x upon 9. Transfer this to right side. So dy upon dx, that is the slope of tangent line, this comes to be, that is 16 upon 9 and x upon y. So this is the slope of tangent line. Now this dy upon dx, which is slope, this is minus 16 upon 9 x upon y. Now question says the tangents are parallel to x-axis. So when tangent are parallel to x-axis, their slope is 0. I had shown in the diagram few days ago, if I have a curve y equal to fx, and if this is the case, this is tangent, and this tangent is having slope 0, that is dy upon dx equal to 0, mean tangent theta is the slope is 0 here. This line, tangent line, is making angle theta equal to 0 with positive x-axis, that is why its slope is 0. So when slope of a tangent line is 0, it is parallel to x-axis. So this tangent is parallel to x-axis as seen in the diagram. So in this case, its slope is 0. So he says parallel to x-axis, when tangent is parallel to x-axis, its slope will be 0. So this means this is also slope, this is also slope. So both values will equal, that is minus 16 upon 9 x upon y will equal to 0. 16 cannot be equal to 0. So that means x upon y equal to 0, which says x equal to 0. Now, if I put this value x equal to 0 in equation of the curve, so I will get the coordinates at which the line is tangent to this curve. So I put the value here x 0, so this will be 0.9, y square 0.16 equal to 1, this will be 0, that is y square upon 16 equal to 1, y square equal to 16, y square equal to plus minus 4. So y will, since it is quadratic, so my points are 0, 4, 0, minus 4. So these are the two points at which the tangent lines are parallel to x axis. So this was part first. So if you have to draw its diagram, it can be drawn. I can show this in diagram, that this as the coordinate axis. Now this is the equation of an ellipse. Let me draw in this way the coordinate axis. So ellipse, it is having the major axis on y axis, that is it will be like this shape. So this is roughly an ellipse whose major axis lies on the y axis. So this is the diagram of this curve. So my points are 0, 4 and 0 minus 4. This is 0, plus 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 1, 2, 3 and 4, 1, 2, 3, say let it be A, B, C, D. So there are four points at which this ellipse is intersecting the coordinate axis. Now my points are 0, 4. This is 0, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Say this is the point. 1, 2, 3 and 4. Say this is the point. So I have the two points. One is C and one is D. So my tangents are parallel to x-axis. So tangent will be drawn in this way. So this is the case where the two tangents are tangent lines are parallel to x axis. So I have drawn a rough sketch of ellipse. So in diagram you can say this is point 0, 4, 0, minus 4. So this was the first case. In second case I can have the slope of k second, slope of tangent lines parallel to y axis. So in this case, slope of tangent line, that is d, dx upon dy will equal to reverse of this 9 upon 16 and y upon x. This is the slope of tangent line which are parallel to y axis, and this is the slope of tangent line which is parallel to x axis. So since tangents are parallel to y axis, in this case dx upon dy will equal to 0, that means minus 9 upon 16 y upon x equal to 0, that means in this case my y will equal to 0. In previous case, that is in first case, x was equal to 0, and in this case y is equal to 0. So if I put this value in my equation, which is x square upon 9 y square upon 16 equal to 1. So in this equation, if I put y equal to 0, so I will get the value of this whole term will become 0 and this will equal to 1. That is x square equal to 9, that means x equal to plus minus 3. So I have two points here, and those points are 3, 0, minus 3, 0. So these are the two points on the curve at which the two tangents can be drawn and they will be parallel to y axis. So if I have to show again on diagram, this was the first case. Now the second case, again axis, xy plane, so my ellipse is roughly, this is ellipse. Now the question is, the tangents, the points are 3, 0. Say this is 3, 0 and this is minus 3, 0. So there are two points. The diagram needs to be, so at these two points I will have the two tangents, and the tangents will be like, in this way, this is the one of the tangent and other tangent is this. So both the tangents, they are parallel to y axis. So this was the second case. So in this way we solve this question, which is question number 13. So after this we come to next question number 14. Fourteenth question says, find the equation of tangent and normal. we have to find equation of a tangent and normal at the equation of curve, which is given as x equal to cos t and y equal to sin t, where value of t is given as pi by 4. So you have to find the equation of tangent and normal on this curve which is given to us. So I have two points given as x is equal to cos theta and y equal to sin theta. This is the equation of parametric form. We can say this is parametric form type equation of a curve. So in the derivatives chapter there was an exercise, and in this exercise there were 5 to 6 questions, and this type of differentiation we had done earlier. So I have to find slope of this curve. So slope of curve can be found if I find slope of this curve. So before I find slope of this curve, if I have to you remember one thing, if you have to draw the equation of a tangent, if we have to find equation of a tangent or normal, there are the two things needed. Number one, we must know slope of tangent, that is dy upon dx, and sometimes it is called m and sometimes it is called tangent of theta, where theta is the angle which tangent line make with positive x axis. The second thing we need, the coordinate of point of contact. So these two things are required if we have to find the equation of a tangent or a normal. So find first the slope. So for finding slope, let us say x is equal to cos t. This I can write as value of t is pi by 4, and pi by 4 is 1 upon under 2. So x, value of x is this much. In the same way, if I put the value of t as pi by 4, so this is 1 upon under 2. So value of y is 1 upon under 2. So my coordinates of point of contact R, which is called x1, y1, 1 upon under 2, 1 upon under 2. So point of contact coordinates are known to me. The other thing, I have to find slope. So for finding the slope, I differentiate this. So this will be dx upon dt. It is minus t, derivative of cos t is minus t, and y equal to sin t. Again I differentiate this with respect to t, this will be cos t, and I have to find the slope dy upon dx. This is given by dy upon dt and divided by dx upon dt. So these questions you might have solved. So value of d by con dt is cos t upon dx con dt. Its value is minus sin t. This will be minus cot t. This will be minus cot t is pi by 4. This is minus 1. So slope is pi minus 1. So dy upon dx is minus 1 at this point. Now I can draw the equation of tangent easily. What will be the equation? Equation of tangent line with slope minus 1 and point of contact is 1 upon under 2, 1 upon under 2. So again using the formula y minus y1 m x minus x1. This is the formula used for finding the equation of a tangent line. So this will be y minus y1 is under 2, let this be x1, this be y1, slope is minus 1, x minus 1 upon under root of 2. So this will equal to minus x plus 1 by under 2 here equal to sign. Minus 1, or I can say x plus y equals to 1 upon under 2. Transfer this to this side. This will be 2 upon under 2. So that is x plus y equal to 2 upon under 2. And this can I write under 2 upon under 2. This will cancel. So this will only root 2. So x plus y equal to root 2, or x plus y minus root 2 equal to 0. So this is the equation of tangent line on the given curve, which is in parametric form. So I have also to draw the equation of normal. This is the equation of tangent. I have to find the equation of normal also. So equation of normal will be equation of normal passing through point of contact is this, and slope is slope of tangent was minus 1, and slope of normal with its negative reciprocal, that is m dash, this will be 1. So this equation will be y minus y1 equal to m dash x minus x1, same formula. So y minus y1, this is 1 upon under 2, and this is 1 x minus 1 upon under 2. So this will y minus 1 upon under 2 x minus 1 by under root 2, or I can say y minus x equals to minus this under 2. Transfer this to this side, this will be plus 1. So y minus x equal to 0, or I can say y equal to x, or x equal to y. So this is the equation of normal, and this is the equation of tangent on the given curve. So this was question number 14. Now I am going to take next question, that is 19.1. Question says, you have to find the points on the curve. Find points on curve whose equation is given as x square plus y square minus 2x and minus 3 equal to 0. We have to find points on this curve at which he says the tangent r parallel to x axis. So this is 19th question. Equation of curve is given to me. I have to find points on this curve at which tangents are parallel to x axis. So let us write equation of curve, which is x square, y square, 2x minus 3 equal to 0. Now if I have to find tangent line on this curve, so I will have to find its slope. So differentiate with respect to x to find slope of the tangent line. This will be 2x, 2y, dy upon dx minus 2, and it is constant, its derivative will be 0. So I can say 2x minus 2 plus 2y dy upon dx equals to 0. Or if I take 2y dy upon dx equals to 2 minus 2x, or dy upon dx will be 2 minus 2x upon 2y. So 2 can taken common upon y. So my slope is equal to 1 minus x upon y. Now he says, question says, tangent line, so this is the slope of tangent. Now question says, slope of tangent line is parallel to x axis. As I have already told, if tangent line is parallel to x axis, its slope is 0. Just as this is a curve y equal to fx, this is point of contact. Here the slope of this line is 0. What is slope? Slope is the angle which the tangent line make with the positive x axis. So here dy upon dx equal to 0, because this line is not making angle theta. Theta angle is here 0. So that is why this is parallel to x axis. So if a line, tangent line, is parallel to x axis, its slope is 0. So its slope will be 0. That will be 1 minus x upon y equal to 0, or 1 minus x equal to 0, which means x equal to 1. So if I put this value in this equation, I will get the value of y. So the value of y will be equation of curve is x square, y square, 2x, 3 equal to 0 at x equal to 1. This will be 1 square, y square, 2 into 1, it is 1, minus 3 equal to 0. So it is y square, 2, 3, 5, 4 equal to 0, y square equal to 4, y will be plus minus 2. So my points are 1, 2, and 1, minus 2. So these are the two points on this curve at which the tangents will parallel to x axis. So this was the question number 19. So for today, these are sufficient. We revise these questions, and next questions, which are 2 or 3 left in this exercise, these I will solve next time. And with the finish of this exercise, this topic, that is tangent and normal, the next topic is maxima and minima. So I will take the next topic, maxima and minima, so next time.